Hey guys, welcome to Some Assembly Required. It's that part of the show where we talk about G.I. Joe customs, toy customs, model building techniques and tricks and all that good stuff. And I'm joined here by my good man, Bart. And we're going to get into some submissions. We put out a call to action on Facebook. Actually, Bart did. And we actually got a bit of response. We got some really, really cool classified customs, and we want to talk about them. We want to get into there. We do want to critique, and something I do want to mention before we get into this: critique is not criticism. Criticism is when you look at something and you go, "Oh, that sucks. I don't dig that," or "I don't like that color," and you just leave it at that. Critique is when you look at something and you say, "Well, you know, I really like that color, but maybe." But like then you would suggest a solution. Like you'd be like, "Oh, okay, I really like the colors the guy used, but maybe he just needs to thin his paint more to get a much stronger effect for next time." So please understand, none of what we're going to do here is bullying or bashing. We're going to look at everything within its own merit. We're not comparing you to some kind of high standard. Yeah, we love you. I don't know how to do that. How do I make a heart with my hand? I'm not millennial enough for that. but yeah, so I just just so you guys know, if it does come across as that we're bashing, then sorry, but that's really not the objective here, and we're not trying to compare you to some kind of crazy standard. Okay, we're all actually learning here. Some of us have more experience, some of us have less, and as I say, it's not the age of the car, it's the mileage, right? So, and also the type of car. I mean, a lot of mileage in a sports car. It's way better than a lot of mileage in a sedan. I don't know. Anyway, cool. So I just want to give it a few more minutes. I did say that the stream was going to start at 10 past. So I just wanted to just want to give guys in the comments a bit of a chance to catch up. And while we're doing that, I'm going to catch up with my big guy, Bart, over here. Dude, what have you been up to? Like, what's been cracking?
Well, I think last show I was in quarantine for the military, getting ready to go overseas to a place I can't tell you, but it is rather warm here, I can say that. So I've been here today, Saturday, a week and a day. It's been a little bit of a challenge. I do run my shop. My boss isn't here because he was lucky enough to get COVID right before he left. So he's been delayed a little bit. So I'm pulling double duty. So it's been keeping me kind of busy, but the workload itself is manageable. I got a great set of guys. So when I'm not here working, you know, 12 hours a day, 6 days a week, I sit in my room and try and get caught up on podcasts and TV shows and sleep.
Yeah, I feel you on that, man. For me, the last, since we did a Some Assembly Required, I've just been busy as usual, surprise. But I did actually go on holiday, which was great, and got a bit of like R&R. Then came back into a, you know, hailstorm worth of work. That's a nice way of saying it without using swear words. it's just been crazy. But in between all of that, I did an unboxing video, and just before that, we released the third part. Second part of Renegades. And that was really cool, Slaughterhouse, and I see a lot of people have really, really dug it. We've got some great comments and some good views, and I've watched it more than once, so that's been something that we've been doing, and bit of top secret stuff, not that top secret, but we are planning the third episode. I mean, we have been, Steven's been very, very hard at work with getting stuff ready for that. So there's been lots of cool stuff happening with G.I. Joburg. We just keep pushing forward and doing cool things. I mean, I've got a few unboxings planned for later. The last one from Dustin was a really cool surprise. Something I was expecting for a while, was actually kind of worried that it got lost in post. There's one more from Jim that I'm waiting for. And then I've got a few things that I actually would like to open on camera, which I've been dying to do because I actually want to play with the toys. So just so you know, I've got stuff in packaging that I want to open, that I want to play with, that I can't get to right now. So feel my pain.
Sweet. Have you made any progress on that crap I sent you?
I have tried. I haven't done – the only thing I've done involving my airbrush was clean it the other day, actually. Yeah. That's about the most exciting – It's been
progress.
It is progress. It is progress. So, guys, I'm going to share my screen. I'm going to share screen one with you. And you should see some kind of Photoshop-ness there. Okay, cool. Awesome. Okay, the whole point here is that I'm going to go to the top of the customs. Sorry, that was a bit of a spoiler. The reason I'm doing this is so that we can... oh, thanks, Greg. yeah, I feel like I've set kind of a standard now, so I got to maintain that. Cool, man. Okay, so yeah, you're going to see me look this way when I'm looking at the screen to check out your comments. You're going to see me look this way when I'm talking about the custom. So I've purposely done it this way. I don't want to know who these customs are from. So I don't want to have that going with any bias. Bart, however, does have an idea of who these are all from, and he can check the Facebook to see who they're from. So I'm doing this cold, which I prefer to do, because then I can look at the art without the personal relationship that I may have with, may or may not have with the guy that submitted. Also, this is not a competition. Yeah, this is not a competition. This is purely about, you know, making like trying to help us get better and whatever. And also, because Bart has a much better understanding of this figure, I'm gonna let him talk first and go and ask him, what has this guy done? Now, this is very cool. And the one thing I just want to say just before I hand over to Bart, one thing I really love about this so far is that pose. That is a great pose right there. I dig that. That is cool. Very nicely handled. Also, I don't know if that gun is the gun that came with that toy, but that is a cool looking gun. And I see a little bit of Action Force 11 in the shot, so I'm totally cool with that. Yeah, but let's hear it, Bart. You know this toy better than I do. So,
I actually didn't get a chance to play with mine before I left. I was too busy. I'm trying to pull up a picture here and see if I can what's different about it.
As you can hear, my keyboard is going clackety-clack, clackety-clack.
I think the only thing I see different here is he's got Bobby's Crimson Shadow weapons
stacked in there. Okay, well, that is already kind of an improvement. Although, to be fair, this Cobra Trooper's gear isn't bad, actually.
Yeah,
it isn't bad. But I like A plus for this pose. This is really, really cool. I really dig this posing. I feel like, and I don't know if I'm imagining this, but I feel like there's a bit of a wash on here somewhere. Like, I don't know, just compared to the pictures I'm seeing on the internet right now, I feel like whoever did this has brought out some of the detail. Like, correct me if I'm wrong, but and our listeners may or may not notice this, so just keep an eye on that chat. But this area here, let me get a better color for you folks there in the real world. This color here, like, that looks like that's been painted on. Also here and also there. I hope, I don't know, am I smoking something or am I right?
I think you may be smoking something, because I'm looking at Facebook here and it looks like it's just a weapons upgrade.
Okay, cool. Sweet. Okay, cool. Well, then, you know, then it's amazing what lighting does, because this shot, it's pretty cool. Anyway, whoever did this, awesome. Like your choices, like your weapon choices. Sometimes that's all it takes.
Dan Szymanski.
Oh, cool. Dan Szymanski. Yay. longtime fan and friend of the show. Ooh, good, I wonder dude. Who did this guy. So awesome. I don't want to zoom in too much. Yeah, it's probably some D-bag. Okay, so the image quality on this is a little bit lower, so I can't go super high into this. This is cool, because then I can actually comment on this before Bart does. and I know exactly who did this one. And you know what? That's all good. Okay, so there's a lot of cool stuff about this toy as well that I really, really like. First thing I'm going to start off with is this here. This, can everybody see it? This is a necessary addition to this backpack. Like, I feel like, irrespective of which character you're trying to make, this backpack definitely needed clips to keep, you know, to keep his rifle and all that good stuff. Cool. This is meant to be Falcon, and it very much is Falcon for me. So what do I like about this? Okay, yes, it looks like Falcon. I immediately thought it was Falcon when I looked at it. That's good. The color choice is really good, like really nice dark colors, dark green, and I can see the camo like popping up here in these sections here.
Yeah, I think there's three different greens on there. It's kind of hard to tell with the lighting.
In the picture, yeah. No, but this is great. This is a bit of a side effect for a lot of the classified Joes for me, but this, I'm not going to hurt the customizer for this. This happens. So that's like negligible. If I could suggest anything, I would have just done a wash on this bag, just a subtle wash. And maybe it's there, but I'm not seeing it because of the quality of the shot or the lighting or whatever.
No, there's not one on it.
Yeah, and then also a wash on the straps, just a slight wash, and just a slight wash on this just to help bring it out just a little bit more, just to tie it in, because I feel like the green and there's so much cool stuff happening here. A little bit of a wash would be great here. This face is awesome. And ladies and gentlemen, we do have the customizer here on hand. Bart, can I ask you whose face did you use for this?
That's Duke.
Are you kidding me? Is that really Duke?
That's pretty much a Duke repaint with a whole bunch of other crap I modified and glued to him.
No, that's
and some soft goods. Yeah, it's there's more pictures on my customs Facebook page. The back and stuff like that. So if you look at the figure, his back, the straps are exactly the same way I made them to match.
That's cool. Also, I like the aerial, the antenna. Sorry.
That's a coat hanger.
That's a?
I think that was a coat hanger. Coat hanger or paper clip, one of the two. And the clips to hold the knife on are also a paper clip.
Nice. Okay, well, that's cool. That's like I like this. This is very good. It's a fun, like, before we move into the next one, I like this because this is like, to me, a very playable custom. Like,
what's soft like, goods?
Yeah, I feel like that's lucky. You can have fun with it. This is badass too. Yeah, that's my initial impression. Sorry, Bart, I wasn't gonna get you to like talk about your own custom.
I didn't even expect it to pop up, honestly.
Okay, no, cool. I just thought it was cool and I had to put it in there. Bart, you go first. What do you like? What are you feeling?
To me, this feels like it like popped out of a Metal Gear game.
Oh yeah.
I believe that's a Punisher head. But to me, this has like a snake feel to it. Everything just kind of like layers, like you would think, you know, a video game action figure would
have. So that too. Like, okay, cool. What else? What else is jumping out to you, man?
It's kind of hard. Let me blow this up.
Oh, hold on. Let me zoom in for you. Let me zoom in.
I'm working on like three different screens on a laptop here. Okay, I like the detail on the pants. I like that. That's cool.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, with the camo.
Uh-huh.
This looks like a roadblock.
Like I was gonna say it looks like a mix of Duke and Roadblock.
Yeah, the vest has been cut down the middle. You can see that. Yeah. That's cool. I like the open vest.
Ah, me too, big time.
Yeah, because if not, then you have to, you know, boil and pop the arms off and
all that, you know, all that stuff. Man.
Yeah, so slitting it down the middle gives you an easy way to take it off. Plus, it looks cool open.
We got some comments here that have popped up since we got to this image. And just some comments I want to respond to quickly. Firstly, hey everybody, what's up guys? So glad that you're with us. Thank you for like chilling out with us. It's awesome. Greg Blanchett, thank you so much for the compliment on my dance moves. My hilarious dance moves. what else? Hey, what's up, MCDJ ACDC? Greg Blanchett, to answer your question, where's the AK from? It is from that Action Force pack. Mm-hmm. That did that. It was like a quick kind of a pre-order bonus incentive short run kind of release that Bobby had done as a small apology for the toys being delayed, if I'm not mistaken. And so yeah, it was kind of like one of those hot limited sort of things. But all of those weapons are being released, but this was like a prototype, like unpainted weapons and all that kind of stuff. So that's quite cool. So I think Dan was just lucky enough to snag one of those. Greg Blanchett says, that looks so awesome. Dutch meets Solid Snake. Now, that was kind of my feeling too, not so much Dutch. I kind of felt like when I first saw this, and I really hope I don't upset or offend the customizer when I say this, but it kind of looked like an angrier Falcon. You know, like if like Falcon, like, yeah, he's like grown up and he's seen shit. You know what I mean? Like that kind of vibe. That was kind of the vibe I got from this. But then also when I look at it, it takes me all the way back to like 1990s comic books in a good way. Like,
You know, this reminds me of Contra, the side scroller.
Yeah. Yeah. It's got a bit of that vibe to it. And it's also got this like really cool, Punisher Warzone feel. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to go on a limb here. This is most likely the Punisher's face or Punisher's head sculpt. And I like that the customizer didn't mess with that. Like, kept it there and kept it in intact, like made it. It's kind of like his own character in a weird way. Okay, but let's start talking a little bit of technique. Love the vest. Wow, it's amazing. Like in the words of Borat, wow, wow, wee, wow. cool choice of green, very natural, very great. Very cool, like sort of almost a gray green that's used here. Also nice choice to keep those gold accents there, like good proportion of color, you know, like there's a little bit of gold, there's a little bit of gray, and then there's like a whole lot of green, and this is very good design sense. I like that because it's a little bit of this, a bit more of that, and a whole lot of that, and it just balances nicely. So go for it. This cut here, along here, very well handled, in my opinion, because that can always go awry. I like how that was done. Also, love that it was done. It gives this character this, like, badass, I've been in the jungle too long. I ain't got time to bleed. Yeah, exactly. One of my favorites. I also dig this. I think these are Gung-Ho's arm pads, which is also, like, great choice, by the way. That's like a hidden accessory on that toy, if memory serves. These look good. I like that you painted this. I'm starting to feel that these are Gung-Ho's legs. Correct me if I'm wrong, and I haven't looked at my Gung-Ho in a bit. I feel like these were done, have been painted over. If they haven't been, no problem, because it's just good color decisions and whatever's made here. Can I give any critiques, like to make it better? What would I do to make it better? Same thing I said about Bart's custom earlier. I would just add a dark green wash over here, a dark green wash. And I'm doing this so that when you watch the video again, you can pause here. I'd put a dark green wash just to bring out some of these details just a little bit more. But I wouldn't like, don't like flood it, like sort of get in there with your brush a little bit and then just bring the wash in like into these little pieces here if you can, just to bring this out a bit more. And then also just on this gray, you can use the same dark green wash just to unify it. Otherwise, you can use the dark gray wash just to help these pop out more. But otherwise, the photography for this is very cool. In future, just a bit of advice. You've got a very strong single camera setup here, so maybe try to get two cameras so that you can eliminate this shadow here. Just for if you want to improve your toy photography and stuff like that. Cool. I hope that helps. Thanks, Lakeside Joes. Yeah.
Now, when you're putting that wash over the whole vest, I like to do it just where your hands would go. You know, like when you zip up or you open it. So just like that area, darken it up a little bit.
Yeah, that's good advice.
Because you have dirty hands, you know, so wherever your hands go, dirt goes.
See, I like it here as well. So to add to what Bart said now, I like having it in here, in these spaces here, because that's where shadow is. And it'll just create this nice natural illusion of shadow. Whoever did this custom, thank you so much for this. This has been a feast for my eyes. Really appreciate this.
Do you want to guess or do you want me to tell you?
No, there's no way I can guess. So you got to tell me. Bum, bada,
bum, bada, bum. You there? I lost you for a second.
I'm here. Yeah, you can tell me. Tell me.
It was Outback Stew.
Oh, awesome. Outback, nice one, dude. I wonder then if this is meant to be old Outback Stew. Because if that's the case, then I imagine he wants to do a little bit of a red hair vibe going on here.
It says it's Jake Bubba.
Oh, it's Bubba. Okay, cool. That's from his line, hey? If I'm not mistaken, Stew. Cool, man. Sweet. Okay, and Gas is in the house with us. Oh, look at all these cool people. Yeah, actually, sorry. Photo Viper said this. I like this comment. It could also be Flint after Lady J died. I do like that. I know that this is meant to be a completely different character, but like, you know, you can go that way. So, sweet. Okay, on to the next one. Let's see. What have we got here? Ooh, okay, now there's a toy I want. That's pretty much the last classified toy I want. Like
Zartan?
I love that Zartan. I think it's so great. I really, really love it. I sing its praises every time I see it. I've actually pre-ordered it, and I found it on Amazon, so I'm going to try and order it from there and get it sent here.
Yeah, I don't think mine have come yet. I think it's BBTS. I think I have them on pre-order.
Oh, yeah. They just haven't come. So you'll get it next year then?
Yeah.
Hey, at least you'll get it. That's one thing about BBTS. They're pretty solid. They're not the fastest, but they're pretty solid. This is not a sponsored video. Yeah, this is not a sponsored video. Guys, okay, so I'm looking at this. Okay, so from what I can tell, nothing's been done to Zartan, and honestly, there's nothing you really should do to Zartan, in my opinion. I think this figure is good enough. But this could also be my limited knowledge of the toy, and when I actually have it in hand, I'll probably watch this video and go, oh, Paul. But the bike is cool, and I feel like the bike has had some work done to it. So I just
put a silver it's here. A Punisher bike with a repaint. I got that Punisher bike because I collect the Punishers, and it's nice. It's a nice bike.
Let me see. Punisher. I'm going to type in Punisher bike into the interwebs, see if I can see the original, just so that I can, you know, be cool on it. Because I've already seen one thing that I really dig, and I've got a nice comment to add to the guy here. But yeah, Bart, do you want to get in here?
Let me pop this up. I think this is all just a repaint of the bike. The bike comes flat black, so it looks like there's some silver on the tank and maybe a little weathering on the motor. I'm not like both of my bikes, neither one of them have ape hangers. I've ridden them. They're difficult to ride where I live because all the twists and turns and hills and stuff.
Yeah.
So for me, if I have Zartan on there, I probably would have cut those bars down a little bit, but I don't know. It just gets tiring with your arms out there like that when you're riding for a couple hours, but that's just me, my personal preference. But I dig it. I might have added maybe like a purple pinstripe around the silver down the side of the fenders or something, just for a little pop. You know, get some dreadnought killers in there, little hints here or there. But that's just me. Other than that, I like it.
Sweet. Hey, I just want to just do a quick shout out just before I start chiming in. Hey, Troy. Hey, party people. And what's up, Renegade Biker 24? And also, shout out to Action Figure Expert. What's up, player? Cool, guys. I'm going to chime in here. I've got some things that I think could be quite valuable to the customizer here. First thing I want to say is I had to look it up. I had to look the bike up, as you saw me. I did it live in real time. I was on the internet. That's what Paul looks like when he Googles. So the first thing I did notice before I even Googled was this bad boy here. So this is cool. And I know why you're doing this, because it gives it a bit of pop, gives it some identity. What I might suggest you do is, whoever did this, is try and measure this out the best you can. And then get like a cool, find like either a cool picture on the internet or maybe put up like a request on the G.I. Joburg group or whatever and go, you know what? Try to find like a Cobra Moray decal, you know, from the Cobra Moray. Just get that picture and then maybe ask me and I'll be happy to do it for you. Ask me to quickly in Photoshop, I can deep etch that for you. And then you go and print this out as a sticker. And I think popping that sticker on here would be so badass. Or if we take like, there's that sort of Destro icon thing that they've done for Destro, for Zartan, they've got this kind of like,
oh yeah,
sort of snake motif thing here. So like, even that, just like to a degree, could look pretty cool there. And that, you know, just straight up do it as a sticker. Go to a print shop, ask them to print you a vinyl sticker, or tell them what you want to do it with and what you want to use it for, and they'll most likely like get you a good sticker. And also a small plug for the Patreon. I just released a set of Red Dog's livery. So that's all of the designs that we use for Red Dog in Renegades Part 2. So if you look at Red Dog's Triple T, you'll see he's got a unique design that is like signature to his Triple T. I designed those for that episode. I'm also doing Mercer, and I'm doing a Mercer, Taurus, and possibly the Sarge himself. Not possibly, very definitely the Sarge himself. And those will be released in time. The Red Dog one is currently available for free for Patreons who join, and you guys can download that and put that as a sticker sheet. And I've done it in all different sizes and different kind of mirror. So, you know, use that for your customers if you want to. So that's the one piece of advice I'd give here. And some compliments. This chrome on this engine, I thought this was factory, but this is not factory, because all the pictures I've seen of this bike, this is all black. So the only thing that makes sense to me is that the customizer here used like a monotone marker and got this chrome look, which I think is just, it looks great. Like, I think it looks cool for this, just to help give it a bit of pop. And it's well done, because it has a bit of a factory finish, and I like the like scratches and stuff here. And
like, yeah, heat got to it.
Yeah, yeah. And I would say like the only thing I would like then add to this is I'm gonna say a wash, but before I actually get into wash, I would say get yourself some nice acrylics, like Vallejo acrylics and whatever, and get yourself like a good sort of a gray color, and then sort of really, so get some gray acrylic. Okay, I'm just gonna say gray acryl. When I say acrylic, I mean water-based. I don't mean tummy or anything. Use like a nice like sort of brush, and then just dot in some like, just dot in a little bit of dirt here in like these crevices here and stuff, and on the ends of the bolts and things like that. I'm telling you what to do, as if like, but like, these are just suggestions. You do them.
Well, you can water down some oil paints too.
Yeah, you could. But the reason I like the acrylic colors, especially if you use like Vallejo, is if you also get the Vallejo airbrush cleaner, it's actually very easy to remove it. So you can just quickly remove it if you make a mistake. So I like that. And that could be quite a bit of fun. And this kind of chrome is nice to practice on. And what will happen is, as you play with it, you might even scratch some of that acrylic off in time, and it'll actually give it a slightly more natural look. And feel free to like put some of that here on the fuel tank as well, just like a little bit of dotting of that. Try to avoid silver. A lot of guys like to use silver for weathering. I'm always like skeptical of that, because I feel like it looks like a Hot Wheels car that's been banging around in a toy box for too long. And just a little bit here, you know, just here on the fairing and all that kind of stuff. I personally wouldn't change the handlebars, but that's just because I'm not a biker. So I don't I can't relate to that. And my artistic instincts just really loves that hard. Like, that just looks cool. Like, you know, ain't nobody going to break my stride, you know.
Hang some tassels off it.
Yeah, man. Like, yeah. Or like a skull. Like, get like a cute like skull like somewhere. Like, and then just like tie it up here and put it. The
Dreadnoughts logo would look good slapped on the side of that tank.
Yeah, exactly, right? That's why I suggested it. Like, have a look at that. And then, like I said, if you ask me very nicely on the Facebook group, I'll quickly I won't make something original for you. I'll just copy somebody else's, like, you know, something that's pre-done, like the Moray sticker or maybe that Dreadnoughts logo, or at least just make it printable for you. You know, I'll find it online and just adapt the PNG for you. I know it's a bit naughty to do that, but we customize, right? That's what we do. I'm not going to sell it to you. So, cool.
The font you used for Renegades, what about that? Just say Dreadnoughts and slap that like diagonal across the tank.
Yeah, you could do that. You could have like Dreadnoughts, you know, cool. Like the Florida chapter or something here on the back as well. There's a lot of stuff you could do with this, but all in all, just wanted to compliment that chrome, and thank you for showing us your awesome creations.
Well, who was that? Who do you think did that?
It's difficult for me to say. There isn't anything here that's like a signifier yet. So who was it?
Mr. Ryan Sweeney.
Ah, it's Ryan Sweeney. Cool. Sweet. Thanks, Ryan, for that. Let's see, who have we got next? Oh, we got a Duke. Okay, so I see here it's just been a straight up get rid of the gold repaint with some camo. I like this. I like this. What do you think, Bart? Does this speak to your sensibilities?
I do, because whenever I got my Duke, I pretty much did the same thing. As I toned him down, but almost left him exactly the same. I darkened him up, his shirt, moved some of his pouches and stuff around, but I didn't change too much other than just darken him up and cut those shin pads off, got rid of all the gold crap, just kind of cleaned him up. But he's pretty classic just the way he looks. I really wouldn't change too much to him. I think they did pretty good.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, the first thing that jumped out at me is this Mamba Bajamba over here. Oof, that's so stunning. Like, sorry, there's a clip there. I like this hardware. This is great. This is a great choice. I don't know if the customizer painted this. If they did, you chose some very good points to give it color. That's very cool. I like that.
I think that's one of Action Forces, and then just painted.
Well, that, you see, okay, well, that's awesome to hear. Like, Bobby Valor, we're making money for you, dude. but kudos to the customizer then, because those Action Force guns aren't painted. They're all unpainted, correct?
Yeah, they're all black.
Yeah, so
at least these ones are. I think the ones that come with the actual production figures will have some paint apps on them.
Obviously, yeah, I imagine that. But these are good color choices. This to me, and it's just something I want to speak out here, and I'm pretty sure this is the case. This is referenced. Like, so whoever did this actually either has the gun on hand, is a gun nut, nothing wrong with that, or has Googled this gun and looked at, like, different stock and color options, or seen it from somewhere and copied that. And that's nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with doing that, because it looks good here. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this is completely original and stuff. But either way, it's a win. I love that. Nicely handled here. This is also cool. This is also a great choice. Instead of painting these pouches like one solid color, it's opted to give it a bit of a, you know, just a two-tone. Two-tone is love. Okay, sorry, I know. I don't mean to be so, like, you know, My Little Pony here about it, but whatever. This is cool. I can't remember on mine. Hold on, let me... Oh. No, okay, well, we'll just throw my toys around. I have no idea where my Duke is right now, because I got to say, out of all of my classifieds, that's easily one of my favorites, and it's odd, because he's, you know, it's Duke, but he's a cool toy. Damn, I don't have him to hand right now. Okay, well, for some reason, this feels new to me. I could be wrong. And then, yeah, all of the golden stuff has been replaced. And also, this camo here has been very well handled. I really like how this camo has been done. Very, very nicely handled. Some great color toning. Yeah, I got to say, this is a very good, to me, this is a very good example of why you would want to paint the gold out of your Duke.
Yes.
Yeah, definitely. Like, this is a good example of. I've seen a lot of guys do it to varying degrees of success. This to me has been one of the better examples, if not probably the best example. Who is this, Bud?
I believe that was also Mr. Ryan Sweeney.
Ryan Sweeney, you are on fire, dude. This is great. Really, really nicely done. Yeah, very. And also clean, a cool, like, shot. It. Also, it's a cool photograph as well. You got some. You know, the lighting is considered here. It's great. Like, it's okay. Let's see who's next. Ah, Cobra Commander. Okay. Bart, you've got this toy, but I don't think anything's been done to CC, but I've got a feeling there's something magical about this throne. Cause I feel like this feels like this was made.
Yeah. It looks like, there's nothing done to the commander, but that is a custom throne, made out of insulation foam.
Yeah.
And the seat is from an eating kit that had a ton of fabric.
I'm just jumping. I think Steven's jumped in on the live stream. Ooh, a live stream.
Yeah, I'm having trouble posting comments on there for some reason. I don't know what's happening.
Yeah, there might be a bit of, maybe because of where you are, they might have a bit of a filter with stuff going out.
I don't know.
Okay, so this throne, anybody who does a throne by hand for Cobra Commander, whether you 3D printed it, did it with foam, whatever, go you, because that's like not an easy thing to do. Actually, for me, the thing that stands out as particularly, like, sort of, or particularly, should I say, rather, are these bad boys here. These are cool. These are cool. Man. I've got a feeling, I don't know why, I've got a feeling this is also Ryan, but if these are Ryan, you must take a photo of the throne. I want to see it.
Yeah, it's a little bit more light for me to highlight some of that, but yeah, it is Ryan.
Yeah, and it's cool. It's also a great pose. Sorry, I know this is not exactly how to pose your toys, but I always think like a bit of a bend, and you know, like a bit more of a dramatic bend as opposed to just, or if you're going to do this, like, put the whole character's emphasis there. Like, what I mean, sorry, I'm being this guy now. So for example, your pose, you know, you can have a bit of contrapposto. So push his chest away, but his head facing the world, and his legs can be in a nice A-frame, and holding that stick, his scepter. Sorry, I know how obscene that looks right now. Hold on, let me just, before I get into trouble with the internet police. But yeah, that's that would be like just a bit of advice for posing that.
Cobra trooper on his knees in front of him with a gun to his head.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm still having trouble posting comments, but I'm reading them. So
cool, man. Thank you.
Steven says, Elliot's on the boob, he's on the tube. That's what I was laughing before. It's...
I'm totally sure. Hello, Chris Barodas. How are you, buddy? Dude, I would... I'm going to... Chris asks, do you think it's possible if I could check out some custom-made action figures of Budo? Chris, if you've got them, send them to us on the Facebook page. If you don't know how to find us, it's G.I. Joburg. On Facebook, and by all means, send me your Budo customs. I will put them on here, and we'll make them bodacious. I made a pun. It's
one of my favorite figures. I'd love to see them.
Dig old Budo. Budo is good. Cool, but that's all I want to say there. Dig it. Love that it was crafted by hand or 3D printed, but just a lot of cool effort that went in there. Awesome. What's cracking? Ooh, Snake Eyes. Okay. Uh-oh. Bart, you go first.
All right, let me pull this guy up here. All right, I dig it. I like a little bit more contrast because he's got a lot going on, so I would have done different shades of black, maybe a little bit of gray, just to separate some of the things. Him being like a stealthy kind of guy, I would have knocked down the belt buckles just so there's no like blingy stuff giving him away. I do like the Valverse, was that MP7 he's got there suppressed.
Yeah, it's a suppress. Yeah.
Yeah. And then the sword, it looks like that may be highlighted on the cutting edge. I do like to do that well. Either I get Molotov, or if it's a small thing like a boot knife or something, I'll just grab the Sharpie and just hit it with the Sharpie real quick. What else we got here? The grenade bandolier, I would probably take that off and cut the grenades off and just put them on his belt.
Okay.
Yeah, that's probably about it. Just separate the colors a little bit because it's like really black.
Yeah. So, yeah, I agree with you on the color separation thing. That is something that we've seen with, for example, with the initial release, with the custom, the convention exclusive, where I believe this is brown. But I don't, so with that kind of choice, I do get it. Some guys are, like, I feel like that's something I can't really critique because I feel like, and I've got a feeling this is Ryan again. Yeah. I feel like he is competent enough as a customizer to know what he wants. And I feel like he wants this guy to be, he wants these Snake Eyes to be like monotoned like that. Mm-hmm. I, I've got a feeling that the silver here was done for a comic book feel. And so I totally get where you're coming from with the realism, because that was the first thing that jumped out at me. I was like, wow, silver buckles and all that.
Yeah, kind of your stuff eye happening. Goes right to his crotch.
Exactly, right. But that is also something that's kind of like, it's very comic book. So that, you know, the sword was handled nicely.
It's subject to opinion. I'm not correct here, so.
Exactly.
If you like it, it's yours. Rock it.
I think, although just guess what Paul's going to do?
Uh-oh.
I'm going to become a meme. You should put a watch on that. And you know what? It doesn't have to be a dark wash. It could actually just be a light gray wash just to help this detail here pop out a little bit and these bolts pop out. Because, I mean, if you're going to put attention there, then make that stand out. Yeah, grenades, all that. This is a superb weapon choice. Do you think this is from Bobby Voller's thing, or do you think this is?
Oh, yeah.
No. Yeah, it's an MP. It's an MP series. Yeah. I had to look again. For a second, I thought it was the Uzi, and I was like, no, that's an MP series. I know, even though I heard you say it, you know, my brain, I was actually just looking at it analytically. I'm going to move on from here because there isn't anything dramatic, and I think we've covered what we want to cover there. And to get to the next one. How are we doing for time? Okay, not too bad. Hey, Jimmy! Kyle, Matthew, you are not late because you are a wizard, and wizards arrive when they mean to. hey, and I'm going straight for the crotch. This is great. I have to put this up here because Jimmy couldn't make it today because he has other things that he has to do. So he is here criticizing us, criticizing you. okay, this is cool. So like I've spoken a lot about this in the earlier part of the episode, and this is still love for me. This is double love, okay? Because this face sculpt, I don't even know where that's from. What a cool looking character. No.
Black Panther movie.
Really? Wow. That is such a great face sculpt for this
book. Killmonger.
No, dude, that's crazy. Although, wow, really? Okay. So all I want to say is this is a great face sculpt, but not of Killmonger. Probably, in my opinion, the best character in that movie, or one of the best characters in that movie. But that's my personal opinion. That's how I feel. But the toy definitely doesn't look like Killmonger. It looks like what I imagine like Heavy Duty should look like, you know, in this line. Or actually, I can't think of anybody else that this suits more than like Heavy Duty. Maybe Bulletproof. Hajedi Onizi's like, did somebody say Bulletproof? this is well handled. I like this on Gung Ho's vest. The removing of all the shininess, just sort of bringing it and making it low key. Guess what I'm gonna say at a wash? Adding Roadblock's arm to this with that great tattoo. That's a good idea. Silver here, cool. Better than the gold. I get it. These gloves, nice choice. Those what? Duke's hands. Also great. This needed a little bit of color pop. I see the color pop has been maintained here into the boots. Boots are super silver. I like this. There's something a bit sci-fi about adding all of this this redness to it.
Silver and red kind of, I don't know. It kind of works for me for some reason. And normally that's not something I would do, but having seen it done, I like it. And this would be cool, like if this was a Caucasian guy and you painted that vest silver and you could make like a super trooper kind of guy out of it. I just like the way those colors, the green and the silver red, go together.
I also love that like Outback Stew has got this serious 90s comic book vibe going with a lot of his customs.
He should like have those two guys like doing like some kind of like high fivey kind of thing.
Yeah, like
cheesy 80s movie kind of like, yeah.
Yeah, like Predator, you know?
Yeah.
You know, like, you know, just that whole, like, you know, like that thing.
Explosion.
That like, yeah, imagine like two of my arms as one arm going, yeah, you son of a bitch. that would be cool. I think, and Stu, nice one here. This red band on the arm really does create this nice sort of shape here. I would say that's the only thing that's sort of missing, is maybe this guy could have done with a red headband. Then we could have had like Contra, actually, like Bart was saying earlier. Like Contra,
I probably would have put a cigar in his mouth or something.
Yeah, a cigar would be cool. So okay, so here's the thing. I think this figure is great as is. Add a wash. That's all I'm gonna say. Add a wash to the silver. That's just me. Do it, don't do it. It's up to you. That's totally cool. From a technical point though, like if I had to do something to try and improve it, I would try to find a few. I would suggest maybe putting on, these are things that you can do, like I think that could make it more interesting. A headband would be cool to make them like, you know, bros. But not necessarily important. It's kind of like a you can do it or not kind of thing. I just, although something I do feel he needs, please, I think find some kind of cool chain or necklace that has got red in it, just so that we can complete the shape, because otherwise the shape sort of cuts off here. Now, I know I'm being like maybe stupidly technical, but I just feel that just feels like that's what's missing. It feels like that's
give him a hairy chest.
Yeah, maybe. but yeah, Stewie, I dig this stuff. I dig how like 90s comic book it is. It's great.
It looks like some kind of like 80s cheesy action movie bros right there.
And I, Toro Uchikado and Rita, is it Rita?
Rita.
Yeah.
Fushima. Okay.
I need to look up Rita Fukushima, Fukushima, because I don't know that actor, but I do know Toro Uchikado.
Cool. Oh, speaking of which,
deadly watches.
Did you finish that Kung Fu show?
I actually am busy getting the third episode. I'm enjoying it. I actually think it's pretty cool. I like the martial arts. Like, it's legit martial arts. I enjoy that. Yeah. I enjoy, sorry to say this, ladies and gentlemen, but I enjoy the martial arts in that more than I did in Mortal Kombat.
I gotta go now. Bye.
But it's like, we're not friends anymore. Okay, so this is cool. I'm just gonna go right off the bat. I like the color choices here.
That camo is nice.
That camo here, this camo is very nice. And I don't know if that's stock camo, if that's camo he did. It's very cool. Also, blacking this out instead of graying it out, that's a nice choice. Axe is a cool weapon. This feels like the roadblock we need, but not the roadblock we deserve, apparently, because something that's always weird, nobody fixes Roadblock's beard for me. Like,
I did. Don't
know if you guys, I know you did. Okay,
I cut it off. I took a razor blade, and that thing came right off. And then I painted in his mustache, because the mustache is there. They never painted it.
Exactly. So that bugs me. Like, Roadie would look so cool.
Oh, and the tattoo, I rubbed that off with rubbing alcohol. I got rid of that thing.
Okay, which is so weird, because that's one of my favorite things on that figure. They give you so little in that toy.
It's distracting.
Really? I dig it. I love that it's like, I'm Roadblock. I'm king of the
jungle. I want a classic, like, mom with the heart tattoo. I think Roadblock would have one of those. He seems like a mama's boy.
Really? I don't know. I don't. Yeah. Okay, Marvin.
You know, the guy that, like... Okay. He's going to protect his mom kind of thing.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. That's most of us on a sort of deep psychological level, I suppose. moving right along into some assembly required and not some analysis required. I like this choice, this color separation. Mm-hmm. I understand how difficult this is to do, and I understand the lighting plays a role here. But the visible stroking here does throw me out a little bit. That's just a personal thing. There's nothing really wrong with that. I see he did do a bit of a wash. Or I don't know if that's just like a sort of a... So the only critique I would actually critique, like the thing I'd like you to change, whoever's doing this, or not what I'd like you to change, but what I think would make this toy a bit better looking. You did such a cool job of creating two-tone, Ryan, on the last sort of paint job that you did, that I think it would be great... on there. I think it would be great on some of these objects here, just to give it that little bit of, just to make them look less flat. And of course a wash. and also like here on the cap, I think just give this like a bit of a two-tone. And I don't like that this knife has a silver handle. I think that would be something that I would personally fix. Otherwise, love it. love this bad boy.
Well, you know who did it.
Yeah, it's Ryan. It's Ryan.
So he put the woodland camo, took the gold off, and gave him Valorverse weapons.
Totally. It's amazing, like, how Valorverse's weapons, and let's not give all the credit to Bobby here. It's amazing how the right weapons change this character. And I saw it when I saw Steven's unboxing of the convention exclusive Snake Eyes. When you have an Uzi in Snake Eyes' hands, it elevates that figure. It's like the 15% it needs to take it out of being something I don't love. Well, actually, it's something I love, but like it takes it a little bit, it escalates it from something I love to something I'm like, I really love. And now I hate mine because I've seen Steven's. You know?
Now, what if this figure from Hasbro came with a helmet? Like V1 had a helmet. This is more of a V2 because of the vest. But I wish people were making helmets because I want helmets for my figures. And I think he would look cool with like the V1 helmet on. But I'm probably the only guy in the world that thinks that.
So. No, you're not, because I have actually seen other people do that. I have seen other people make helmets for this guy. And Roadblock does look cool with a helmet.
Okay.
I dig it. Gung Ho. Okay, so I think just some basic stuff was done here. Sorry, I'm zooming in too much.
Yeah, they took the Nazi symbol off his chest. I hate that thing. It looks like a big Nazi SS boot stomping. It's that thing is terrible. I mean, the guy looks like a skinhead with that tattoo. He's got the mohawk. You just never take that hat off that figure. It's horrible design.
Okay, so I like the mohawk. I dig
it. I like the mohawk, but with that chest tat that Hasbro gave him?
Yeah.
Bad choice.
Okay, so Ryan, you get 3 hearts from Bart for this chest decal that you've popped here.
I give you 3 Yojobergs for that.
He gives you 3 Yojobergs for that. I like your party blooper here. Thank you. This is great.
Bobby's.
Hey?
That's Bobby's.
I know it's Bobby's.
Yeah,
Bobby's.
The canister spins too. It's pretty cool.
Oh, that just makes me, you know, I'm very excited that I've got a weapon pack coming with, you know, a swarm figure and a what are those guys called? Steel Brigade. Yeah, I can call it Steel Brigade because
that's what they're called.
Now, right? Right. Yeah. So exactly. So so I feel like aside from that, there isn't really much that's done to this figure. But then again, to be fair, was there anything that you really needed to do to Gung Ho to make him better?
Yeah, get rid of that chest hat.
Yeah. But he's already done that. I mean, aside from that, what
looks
else?
Looks like he painted the knife too.
Oh yeah, he may have painted it a handle. Yeah, that's no, it painted this silver. That's
The blade silver because it comes all black.
I still want to paint these on mine. I'm thinking of painting these like a bit of an olive drab, just to pop them out of the plastic a bit, so they're not just like a shape.
Looks like he said he just put some Valorverse weapons on it, but obviously he changed the chest tat too. So
yeah, no, this is really cool. This is like it's much better.
Yes.
Also, but I know you feel strongly about the original. The original doesn't offend me, and I am a little bit Nazi sensitive as well, to be fair. Like, I hate them. I'm putting that out there, and I'm sorry, and I don't care if it offends people. Nazis suck. But, like, it doesn't bug me. But seeing that, now that I've seen it, now I want that on my Gung Ho. Now I want a proper USMC. Like,
my Gung Ho's completely different. I'm not even using that torso. I got a completely different torso. I'm putting his head on, and then Bobby has that was it BBTS? I think he had that exclusive declassified set, and I'm gonna try and put it on.
With
yeah,
the cover. Yeah.
I think I'm gonna try and put that on. The body's a lot more bulkier, just because I wanted Gung Ho to be like buff. So once it gets here, I'll see if it fits. If not, I might have to switch back to his original body. But yeah, that chest tat, whatever I do with the original body, I think I'm just going to paint some spandex shirt on him or something. I don't know. Rub it off with alcohol. I can't stand that.
I'm going to ask Ryan where he got this decal from.
Bad Mother Tattoos or whatever. They sell them.
Oh, okay.
I think that's where everybody's getting theirs from. There's a couple dudes out there that do them, but I know that guy does like a bunch of them.
Wow. Look at that. I sort of saw that in the shots before, and I was like, am I imagining it? Is it
3D print? There's a dude that does them in different colors.
This is very cool. That is awesome. Like that is just awesome. Like, I don't care about Duke. Duke is just there to make this.
That's kind of rude.
No,
I don't care about Duke. Get him out of the photo.
There's nothing wrong. I mean, we discussed this Duke in detail.
I know.
This is great. This is so great. I can't tell if the canopy opens though. It looks like, oh yeah, okay, it can. There's an air hole there.
Mm-hmm.
That is awesome. That is beautiful. Like, even this, like these. Okay, I wonder if these are no. Wow, that is really awesome.
I don't know if he painted that one. I know there's a dude that 3D prints those, I'm pretty sure, in green and gray.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if they did this in yellow and blue, but yeah, they're nice. I think the guy does like vamps and all kinds of other stuff.
Mm. Yeah, like, dude, this is, yeah, okay, so the color choice is odd for me. Okay, to be quite like honest, there's nothing wrong. I mean, they're complementary colors. It's just an odd choice to go for, considering how sort of realistic Ryan has gone with his other work. So the only thing is, for me, I feel like this is maybe just him getting ready to paint. I don't know, or he's going for like maybe a Dreadnought feel or a Fun School Eco feel Force. Or something. Eco-Force.
It's Eco-Force colors. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's cool that it exists. That's actually crazy. Sorry, I mean, this is where I'm like, okay, cool.
Do you need to be alone for a minute? Maybe dim
the
lights?
No. So on 3D printing, this is something that drives me crazy. And I'm going to mention the Lunge backpack now. This is why we haven't released the Lunge yet. We got a new 3D printer that doesn't do this. Okay? When I say we, I mean Jared. and then we're still casting molds from that. So it's not going to have that, these steps. I understand that this is part of the charm of 3D printing. Although what's cool is you can file this, and you can, if you use quite a thick primer, you can actually fill a lot of this up. So this actually requires a little bit of work if you want it to look toy, like you want to get it to get to like a really nice standard. Some Blue Angels colors. Yeah, that's also true. So like, I would have personally, just because I can't stand that, those ripples, I would have smoothed that out the best I can. And then like done like a good strong primer coat over that just to get it there. And also, like, I'm saying this because if Ryan wanted to still do that to this, he can. And if he's happy with this as it is, that's also cool. Like, I feel like it's one of those, is the juice with the squeeze, or is it just more fun to actually have this cool big Skyhawk to play with, you know?
Yeah. Printed lines is why I don't buy a lot of printed stuff unless it's like high end, and then it costs me a bunch of money because I don't want to put the effort into sanding everything and then priming it. I just want to get it, wash it, paint it.
Exactly. No, I feel you on that. So, okay. So my whole treatment on a vehicle like this, because we got very little time now, I would try to discolor these panels. So like in this case, I mean, Ryan, we're speaking hypothetically now. Okay, dude. So like, don't feel that you need to do this. This is just what I would do. I would use a slightly more desaturated blue just for here, just to discolor it a bit, so that there's a little bit of panel discoloration in this, just because at this size, people can appreciate that, as well as the original 1:18 scale as well. A little bit of chipping and stuff here around where the rivets are, just to sort of indicate that there is work done, that these panels do get removed and changed and whatever. Actually, I wonder if the panels on this are removable, like the modern era Skyhawk.
Well, you could get Meng bolts and glue those on, and that would give it a real like armored kind of look to it.
Yeah, that's true too. Another cool trick to make rivets is to actually use people who do sewing have it. It looks like a little buzzsaw that you like roll onto stuff and it makes little holes.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. I've got one here. It looks like this.
Yeah.
Let me get my hand behind it. And you can sort of see there's like a bit of a serrated edge.
Pizza cutter.
Yeah, it's basically a little pizza cutter. And this makes rivets real good. The only catch is that the spacing of the spikes obviously determines the spacing of your rivets. Duh. And then also...
well, that makes innies, not outies.
Yeah, mine. This one makes innies. Yeah, outies, that's like a whole different ballgame.
Yeah, let's get some Meng bolts.
Yeah. What is that again? Or what? A Meng.
Meng. M-E-N-G bolts. Google it. It comes on a sheet, and there's probably a couple hundred of them on there. And
is that made by the company Meng, who do model kits like the tanks and armor and all that stuff?
Yeah, and you can get them in different sizes. I mean, they're super small. They're good for big Joe vehicles like a Rolling Thunder. That's what I tend to use them on. Real good for the 6-inch vehicles because they're super small, but they're too big for a regular Joe vehicle. It would look like a big like bridge girder bolt or something on the side of it. But it comes in a big sheet, and you'll have the bolt side, and then you'll have the nut and the bolt side. So you just cut them off the sheet.
Nut.
Yeah, and then you just super glue them on. Use a X-Acto knife point and just dab it on with the point, and you can put them anywhere. Once I found those things, they saved me a ton of time and trying to think of ways to make rivets, because you could take super glue and a toothpick, you know, and just put little dots everywhere, but they're not really uniform.
Yeah.
These are super cheap. There's a whole ton of them in there. You could probably even mold and cast them, make them yourself. You just slice them off the sheet, pop them on, slice it off, pop it on. Gives it a lot of detail. And there's even ones that are like a spiky, almost like bullet point. And I want to try and get some of them, use them maybe on like a dreadnought vehicle or something like that.
Sweet.
Yeah. M-E-N-G.
M-E-N-G.
Yep.
Okay. Now the resolution on my mouth is funny. Okay. I'm going to post this comment. I'm going to pop it up here. Photo Viper says it would really pop with some faction stickers from Toy Hacks. I agree.
Are they doing like 6-inch vehicle stuff? I haven't been on their site in a while because I got a stack of decals.
I don't know if they're doing for the scale yet, but I'm like super overexposed there now. Hold on, let me just, and I probably have been for a while, but then again, at least the focus of this episode hasn't been me. Thank goodness. you could probably go for like out of scale stuff, like just for like insignia, like G.I. Joe, United States, maybe some of the serial numbers and things you could actually get away with. Maybe even some of the stars, you know, like the star motif, like that, you know, just when you have the normal star or...
Yeah, off of any big vehicle or like the Defiant or something like that.
Yeah, you could probably get away with some of those, definitely, at the scale. That said, I wouldn't be surprised if Toy Hack starts like doing that or has already done that. So coming back to this bad boy, this is very cool, Ryan. I mean, I'm just jealous that you have this. This is great. and the only way I would like make it better, if it was mine, for example, and I had to take it on as a project for myself, I would do a lot of discoloration on these panels. I'd also work into these engines a bit, giving them a little bit of like exhaust, you know, like fume, dirt and things like that, that catches up in here and all that. And you can really have a lot of fun with that, with the streaking, you know, by using like streaking grime products from companies like MIG and Vallejo and whoever else, because like everybody and their dog now does that. You can
He has decals on the way.
Cool. Okay, so there you go. So he's already like, he already knows what he needs to do to this. Rivets, yeah, that's one thing. Although aeroplane rivets are innies, if I'm not mistaken. So
Audis.
Really? Because
yeah, I'm around aeroplanes a lot.
Okay. Yeah, but I mean, on this size scale, I don't know. Would Audis look good on this scale?
It's whatever you want to do. It's yours.
Yeah, true. Oh, there you go, guys. There you go. So now you know that, you know, that's something you can think about.
And that's half the battle. Always have to be,
that is half. He said it.
I went there.
If we made this a drinking game, you would do shots.
Now, what I want to know is, if you put the figure in there, will the canopy shut? Because I know a lot of my vintage figures, it's like popped open because the head's jammed up in there.
You see, that's just because you're not Steven.
Just Steven, put the head out the window.
No. Steven can put that toy in there and it's in there. That's it.
Like that Cobra Asp. You got to fold that guy in half to get him in there.
True. Yeah, no, Steven does all the tricks. He knows, like, he's like, he'll get it in there. You know, he'll get the toy in there. And I got it. That's always been an inspiration to me, because as a kid, I didn't care. I also did the same thing. But like now, as a grown up with grown up sensibility, I'm just scared of breaking my toys. I mean, yeah. This awesome. One of the cool. If you guys checked out the unboxing, I got an ambush. Let's just see if that autofocuses. Should come autofocus, you beast. Anyway, sorry about that, guys. Normally it does autofocus pretty well. Anyway. I got this really cool ambush, and I mean, I have a few, and ambush is great. And I have the weirdest luck with ambush, I must say. The one I bought at JoeCon, for example, had a broken calf. And then, yeah, anyway. But his arms are quite like stiff. Like he's got this one arm here, and I'm like too scared to like pull it out there. Oh, that feels freaky out. Like I'm scared I'm going to break it. And like if I was a kid, I would have just been like, meh, you know, like whatever. And so, yeah. So anyway, so there's a bit of like work that needs to be done. This needs to be worked in a bit. I feel like this ambush has been played with, though, because it feels like those joints are stuck because like maybe he was like dropped in like a cereal bowl or something and something caked in there. Anyway, whatever.
Take him in the bathtub with you and give him a good scrubbing.
I will do that. I take all my toys into the bathtub with me. And I don't know if that's full disclosure or too much information.
TMI.
TMI. Oh, there we go. Now the autofocus works. Yay. Hello. I'm Ambush. I like to hide and seek.
Hey, Paul, if you have any questions on that Skyhawk, Ryan's in the chat now.
Hey, cool. So, Ryan, you called us at just the right time, dude, because we're about to close off. And all I want to say is, man, like you've submitted some fantastic customs, and also this 3D Skyhawk, or 3D printed Skyhawk, is very, very cool. Is that something you made yourself, or is it something that you purchased? Yeah, we'll get our response in a second. But yeah, guys, yeah. So Ryan, also please have a look through the stuff. I hope that we got some things right. If we didn't, please put it in the comments. You can be like, well, actually, gentlemen, I did this and I actually did that. And you guys are a bunch of nincompoops because how could you not see my wash on this? Yeah. So
he said he bought it.
He bought it. Okay, cool. Yep. Because it's very cool. And I'm very excited to see what you do. So please send us some pictures as you do more, because I'd love to have another one of these review sessions. Which brings us to guys, if you're in the comments and you have done some kind of toy custom, any kind of toy custom, now you've seen how we deal with it. You see, we're not mean. We're not like, oh my God, like this guy is the worst customizer ever. You can see how we chat about it. So please feel free, feel brave, be brave. Come and show us your customs. And don't worry, like it's the best you can do for that day. That's all I care about. That's all anybody should care about when you do this stuff. So put it up here. We'd love to see it. We'd love to talk about it. As you can see, we've had a lot of fun talking about it. The time just flew by. Yeah. I had a lot of fun.
It comes down to, if you're happy with it, screw what anybody else thinks. But exactly. That's just my opinion. It's exactly. Mine. It's for my collection. If I'm happy with it, goes on the shelf.
Sweet. You see, there you go, guys. And if you don't like it, be like Jim and just completely trash it and restart it. You know?
Yeah. Or use it for parts.
Oh, exactly. but guys, yeah, thank you so much for joining us today, and checking out some of these awesome customs. I hope that you feel inspired, and I hope that you've found a little bit of courage to come and show us yours. I believe one of you earlier said that you got to get round to this one day. Well, how's about today? Do it today. Yeah. Yeah, you know.
Ask questions. We're here to answer them.
Exactly. We're not like, we may not be the best guys, but we are guys that can maybe help. So by all means. And maybe like I'm always open to somebody doing stuff and then I get to ask them, which is also great.
I've learned from a lot of guys just by seeing their pictures and then just message them like, hey, how would you do that?
Exactly. Exactly. That's how you get good. You also shouldn't listen to random desert scorpions because they are dangerous. They're toxic. Cool, guys. Until next time, Same time, well, not same time, but same place. And we hope to catch you soon. We most likely will have Jimmy on. Maybe we won't have Bart or whatever. But I know Bart has got himself a new hobby. He is now painting very small little soldiers that look like this. He's painting these things. And maybe we should talk about some of these little things in an episode. I think that might
most
be the next
one. Most of them came in the mail. I got the five Space Marines. I'm still waiting on the other ones to come in. So
you see,
but that won't be till November when I get home.
Cool. Well, I think we should still talk about them anyway. It's going to be our I think that'll most likely be our next chat, and then I'll show everybody some progress on Boba Fett as well.
Because I don't know crap about 40K, like zero.
I know like very little. Jimmy knows very much.
Him and
him and Luke. Luke,
why did I bring like that name?
Luke is like a walking encyclopedia on that.
Well, he's worked for Game Workshop, so
So he knows something. He knows something.
Yeah.
Cool. Anyway, guys, until next time, take it easy. Stay cool, stay safe, stay awesome as you are. And please, comment on the video if you have any questions or anything. And until next time, be cool. Cheers. Goodbye.
Berg.
Berg. Wee backflip.